This lecture will deal with the terms involved in an annuity and also calculating an ordinary annuity. In a previous chapter, we talked about the present value and the future value in accounts. Money is put in to an account, and we're looking at what it grows into for the future value. But that's putting a lump sum in and getting a lump sum out. Annuities are, instead of a one single deposit, are a series of equal payments made at regular intervals, whether into an account or away from an account, which for most people is much more affordable and practical. We have two types of annuities. One is called an ordinary, and what makes it an ordinary annuity is that the payments are made at the end of each period, whether it's at the end of the month, end of the quarter, end of the semi-annual period, or end of the year. The time in between payments is called the payment period. The time from the first payment through the final payment is called the term of the annuity. And we've seen the word term before used when we're talking about loans. The length of the loan is referred to as the term. When we have an annuity, we have compound interest being added, which means after each payment, there is interest being calculated, it's being added on to the previous balance, and is accumulating interest on interest. The total amount of money in the account at the end of the term is called the amount of the annuity, or future value of the annuity, what it has grown into. And let's take a look at how we are going to calculate an annuity and exactly how it works. The formula for calculating the amount of annuity is to take the payment, the regular payment, and multiply it by the number from an annuity table. And we'll see that that number is based on the frequency of the payment or compound interest and the number of calculating periods, similar to when we were determining future value or present value using the tables. So here is an annuity table. Across the top of each column is the interest rate per period, and the rows represent the number of periods in the annuity. In other words, the number of payments or deposits being made. So let's look at this first example. $7,500 is deposited semi-annually for 10 years at 6%. Compound the amount of the annuity and the interest earned. In other words, what will this grow into? So twice a year, this individual is depositing $7,500. That deposit is growing with a compounding interest rate of 6%. We need to determine what the interest rate per period is. So we will take 6% divided by 2 because it's semi-annually, which gives us an interest rate per period of 3%. How many total compound periods will there be for this annuity? It's being calculated twice a year. And the length of this annuity is 10 years, so 2 times 10 will be 20. We will look where that I value and that N value correspond. This will be the value then that we will take from the table and multiply the regular deposit. So 7,500 times 26.87037 will result in the final value or the future value of this annuity after 10 years. How much of this money is actually deposited by the individual and how much of it is the interest that's earned? Well, to determine that, we need to determine how much money is being deposited in this account in the first place. Twice a year, $7,500 is being deposited for 10 years, so that means there's 20 payments of $7,500. This amounts to $150,000. The difference between the total value or the future value of the annuity less the amount that has been deposited in there will give us the earnings or the interest earned. So in this 10 years, this account has earned interest of over almost $52,000. In this next example, we have $3,500 being deposited quarterly for 4 years at 10% compounded quarterly. Compute the amount of the annuity, in other words, the future value that it will grow to, and the interest earned after the 4 years. Just like the last problem, we're going to use our annuity table. We need to calculate the I interest rate per compounding period and the number of compounding periods. It's paying 10% compounded quarterly, so we divide it by 4 to give us a 2.5% interest rate per compounding period. N, the total number of compounding periods, 4 per year, for the term of this annuity, 4 years, gives us 16 compounding periods as well as deposits. We will see from the table where that I and N value particular to this problem intersect. That's our multiplier that we will multiply the regular deposit to give us the amount of the annuity at the end of 4 years. Next, they're asking us what is the interest earned. Before we determine that, we need to know how much money was actually deposited in this account. So we will take the regular deposit of $3,500 and times it by the total number of compounding periods or deposits being made. 4 times a year, because it's quarterly for 4 years, gives us the 16. So of this balance, 56,000 of that is coming from the individual. The difference between the amount of the annuity and the payments will give us the interest. So in this 4 year period, this account grew or accumulated interest equal to $11,830.77. Let's look at one more example. We're given that $900 is deposited annually into an account paying 5% for 18 years. Compute the amount of the annuity and the interest earned. Just like the last two problems, we need to calculate the interest per compounding period and the number of compounding periods. 5% compounded annually means we divide by 1, which isn't going to change that. Annually, once per year for 18 years, means there will be 18 deposits. When we look that value up on our annuity table, you should find this value, 28.13238. To find the annuity value, we will multiply that number by the regular deposit, in this case $900, to give us an annuity value of $25,319.14. To calculate the interest earned, we need to first determine how much money was deposited in the account. That's $900 annually, in other words, each year for 18 years. And we have that here. Once that's determined, we will subtract those deposits from the annuity amount to give us the difference or the interest earned. So a little over $9,000 is the interest earned on this account over 18 years.